Over the course of April 2019, a group of friends and I spent three consecutive Saturdays around the Virginia Railfanning hotspot of Front Royal. Front Royal is a noteworthy spot for Virginia rail fans as it is the intersection of three Norfolk Southern lines. From the south and continuing north is Norfolk Southern's H line, which turns into the Roanoke District a few miles south in Shenandoah. From the east is Norfolk Southern's B line from Manassas, Virginia, and from the west is Norfolk Southern's B line extension, which runs to Stockford. Over the course of the three Saturdays, we saw so many trains and so many rare catches that I decided to make all three Saturdays one big video and dub it the Front Royal Trilogy. The morning of April 6th started out with a thick layer of fog covering most of the tracks around Front Royal, Virginia. We started off at Success, just a few miles north of town on the NSH line. Our first train would be northbound Manifest 16T, Irondale, Alabama, to Allentown, Pennsylvania. Not 5 minutes after 16T came southbound continuous welded rail train 913. quick reposition found us at Front Royal Yard, a few miles south of town on the NS Roanoke District, known by rail fans as the Shenandoah Valley Line. This yard is home to one of many Norfolk and Western CPL signals that remain on this line. Quick reposition found us in downtown Strasburg, Virginia, just a few hundred yards east of R.R. Donnelly. This line serves only one industry now and is worked by NS local train K91. This is a rare sight to see K91 in daylight in downtown Strasburg, as this move almost always happens at night. More information on the railroads of Strasburg, Virginia can be seen in one of my most recent videos. Upon our arrival back into Front Royal, we catch southbound manifest train 35Q. Thank you. We hold tight at success for another southbound manifest train, this time in the form of 13R. Trailing 6th out of 6 units on 13R is an industry switcher. We make our way about a mile up the track as the parade of southbounds continued. Next up is southbound intermodal 228. 228 will make a stop a few miles south of our current location at the Virginia Inland Port. Providing an intermission for our parade of southbounds is northbound intermodal train 202. Thank you. The next float in the parade of southbounds is southbound loaded coal train 776. Continuing the seemingly endless parade of southbounds is southbound intermodal train 203. I shot this train in downtown Boyce, Virginia, which is home to a former Norfolk and Western depot. A few miles south of Boyce is the town of White Post, Virginia, where I caught our third loaded coal train of the day. Much like Boyce, White Post is home to another NNW structure. However, unlike Boyce, the structure at White Post is a former freight depot. While beating my path home for the day, I managed to shoot one more train on the NSB line. I made a stop at Busthead Road in Broad Run, Virginia, just in time to catch westbound intermodal train 214. We'll be right back. The morning of April 13th kicked off with a bang. We intercepted northbound intermodal train 202 at Acorn Hill, the signal at the south end of the siding which resides in Bentonville, Virginia. We chased this train with the intention of shooting a handful of color division light signals that still reside on both southern street lines between Front Royal and Shenandoah. From Bentonville, we hightailed it to Front Royal. This CPL is at the south end of the siding we shot 780 at on the prior Saturday. It wasn't long until the action continued. Next up was southbound manifest train 35Q, with rain from the previous night's storm still very much evident. We chased the train east down the B line before ending up in the small town of Rectortown, Virginia, which lies just a few miles west of Marshall. A quick shuffle over to the nearby siding of Allison provided us with another daylight run of NS Local K91. While K91 did not run all the way to Strasburg on this day, we still managed to shoot it, working a few local industries in Marshall. Here we can see K91 dropping off loaded I-beam cars at Capitol Building Supply, an industry located in Marshall, Virginia. Continuing our trek on the B-line, we made our way back to Rectortown for a northbound empty hopper train, NS-777. Chase this train back up the B-line. Our next stop was Markham, Virginia. Closing in on Front Royal, we made a stop at the Fiery Run Road crossing in Linden, Virginia for southbound Manifest Train 13R. Thank you. Today's heavy action continued as southbound intermodal train 228 made its way into Front Royal to work the Virginia Inland Port. We shot this train at Ashby Station Road, just a few miles north of Front Royal. We stuck around at Ashby Station Road to see southbound local K46 making its way to the small yard in Front Royal. Following K46, we made our way to Riverton Junction, just a mile north of downtown Front Royal. Riverton Junction is the meeting place of every line that runs in and out of Front Royal. We made it here just in time to catch 228 again after working the Virginia Inland Port. The train can be seen exiting the H line and entering the B line. Following 228 was loaded coal train 776. Unlike 228, this train continued south on the H line, which will eventually turn into the Roanoke District in Shenandoah, Virginia. The action on April 13th was seemingly non-stop. Next up was southbound intermodal 203. In the lead of 203 is NS-SD70-ACE number 1074, the Delaware, Lackawanna, and Western Heritage. Next up was northbound empty continuous welded rail train 915. This train originated in Front Royal Yard just a few miles south of our current location, and in the lead are the two engines off of the earlier K46. Following the 915 north was another oddball symbol, this time in the form of NS-23Q, a northbound bear table train.
Thank you.
The evening of the 13th was a testament to how busy Front Royal can really be. Not 30 minutes after 23Q was another intermodal train, this time 214. Note is that Front Royal is home to more than one Y. While Riverton Junction is by far the most used Y in town, there's also a Y located in Front Royal Junction. This Y leads to a rarely used industrial spur which goes right into downtown Front Royal. While making my way home, I stopped at the Exxon station in Linden, Virginia to catch one more train, this time in the form of westbound manifest 36Q.
Is that an elevator?
Yes. 4.80 defect. Coltrane.
Four, two, no, it's not. 8, 0, defect.
While April 20th was our least active of the three Saturdays we spent around Front Royal, we did manage to catch more foreign power than the other two. The morning started out with a very unexpected but very welcome surprise of a very late eastbound intermodal train 213. After 2:13, I made my way to Front Royal, Virginia once again for our normal customers. First up was southbound manifest train 35Q. Thank you. 35 Q's tail end passed us, it slowed to a stop to meet two northbounds, the first of which was manifest 12R. The second northbound, which 35Q had to meet, was NS202. Thank you. train action on this day was much slower than our past two Saturdays, as we had to wait almost 2 hours for our next train, which would come in the form of southbound 13R. Today's parade of southbounds continued, however this parade had a much longer wait between floats. Next up was Intermodal 228 passing a UP locomotive with a locked axle sitting in a siding in Berryville, Virginia. About an hour later came yet another southbound, this time southbound loaded coal train 740. including the southbound parade, was intermodal 203. Would run around 740 at Marsh Run, giving us time to reposition to chase 740 down the B-line.